Hey folks, welcome back. So this time I'm going to be making this nice little desk tidy, which of course you can use to stick your pens, paper clips, all that kind of junk which ends up on your desk in. So the first aspect of this project is to make the little tray which you might stick your paper clips and other bits and pieces into. Now to make the little tray, I'm actually going to be using this large 45mm router bit, like you can see with what I've done to this test piece here. Now because this is a bearing guided bit, I'm going to remove the bearing and I do still have this little nub which holds the bearing to contend with. So what I'm going to do is take this small round nose bit and by making a pass with that to begin with, I can create a small clearance for that little nub. So next up, I'm going to begin work on the cup, which will hold the pens and pencils. And for that, I've got this log, which I've had drying for a while, and it's got some really beautiful spalting, which should work really nicely. Now to begin shaping the cup, I'm going to use a rough and gouge. Now using a parting tool, I'm cutting a tenon on one end so that I'll be able to hold this using my chuck. And now I'm marking out just over my final height so that I've got a bit of room to make some mistakes. Right now I'm cutting a recess in the bottom so that I'll be able to reverse this for hollowing. And with it flipped around, I can begin to hollow it out. And now to smooth out the inside of the cup, I'm using a side cutting scraper. Right, so there we go, the cup's almost finished now, but because I don't want this deep recess left on the bottom, I'm actually going to flatten that off, and to do that, I'm just going to flip it round once more. And if I gently hold it on the lathe, I should be able to take some light passes and flatten up the bottom. So now that I've made the two parts of this desk tidy, I want to join them together. And so what I'm actually going to do is to make a cutout into the tray to accept the cup. Using the bottom of the cup, I can line up the two edges and mark round that with a pencil. And over here at the bandsaw, I can cut just shy of that line. So there we go, after a fair bit of careful sanding, I've got a reasonable join between the two parts. Unfortunately, one thing I was finding when I was sanding this was it was very difficult to get a nice tight joint here between the two parts. Now, even when I did come close, the result just looked a little bit odd. So instead of doing that, what I'm going to try and do instead is just to take a sort of cut a small flat on each side, and hopefully the result will look a little bit better. As you can see, what I actually decided to do was to cut a small chamfer leading in towards the cup. And now if I flip round to show you the other side, you can see after a little bit of rounding off of that chamfer, I think the result is pretty good, and I think I'm happy to leave it at that. Now, one final thing that I want to do to this tray before I can join the two parts together is to round off the end. Right, so now I'm ready to join these parts together. So hopefully to do that, I'm going to be able to use a couple of dowels. Now, what I'm planning to do is just to drill a couple of holes into here to place these dowels, and then I will drill a couple of shallow holes in here to meet those. Drill the holes, I'm just going in at an angle, and then as I've got a bit of depth, I can bring the drill up straight. So now, using those in place, I'm actually going to mark the center of each dowel so I can transfer the lines. Using those marks as a reference, I was just able to mark these two points of where to drill. Now, theoretically, because I haven't hollowed all the way to the bottom, I should be able to drill at these points without coming through to the inside. But because that is a risk, I'm of course going to be very careful whilst I am drilling. Right, so those parts just go together like that, and now I'm ready to glue them. Because I don't have a super tight joint between the cup and the tray, I'm actually going to use some fast setting epoxy to glue the parts together instead of using regular wood glue, and hopefully that'll give me a better bond. And I'm also just going to add a bit of clamping pressure to bring it together. Now, before the glue cures completely, I'm doing some cleanup with a chisel.
I finish off cleanup using a sander, as well as softening over all of the edges. And finally, to finish this, I'm just applying a few coats of finishing oil, and it should come up really nice.
And of course, once it's dried, it's ready for use, and you can stick all your pens and pencils and other things into it around your desk. Right, so I hope you all enjoyed this time's video. Now, if you're not already subscribed to my channel, be sure to do so right here to be updated of more woodworking and wood turning videos when they go up. That's it for this time. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.